It's 170 kilometers long, it's 500 meters tall, 9 million people will be living there, and in the middle of the desert. My name is Greg, and I'm an experienced civil engineer, and I'm gonna be reacting today to the line, the ingenious design of the city of future. So let's have a look what they got for us.
For too long, humanity has existed within dysfunctional and polluted cities that ignore nature.
That's the
truth. Now, a revolution in civilization is taking place. Imagine a traditional city and consolidating its footprint, designing to protect and enhance nature. The line will be home to 9 million residents.
And 9 million residents. This is crazy. That's what I said at the beginning. This is like London. This is like New York. So imagine all these people in that line. It's crazy. Let's have a look.
With a footprint of just 34 square kilometers.
34 square kilometers. So imagine how they squeeze all that population there. Let's have a look.
And we are designing it to provide a healthier, more sustainable quality of life.
That's what we definitely
need. The line's communities are organized in three dimensions. Wow. Residents have access to all their daily needs within 5-minute walk neighborhoods. And the line's infrastructure makes it possible to travel end-to-end in 20 minutes.
Guys, just so you can realize, 170 kilometers is like a distance between London and Birmingham. So imagine this, in 20 minutes, covering that distance. Even our new HS2 not going to be able to do that. So this is crazy. That design is great.
Resulting in zero carbon emissions. By leveraging AI technology, services are autonomous, saving you time and effort.
I see some flying drones and it looks that AI technology. But to be honest with you guys, it's already here. We got drones, everything can be delivered now. I think it's more about the regulation, how it's all going to be done. But it looks like taken from the future, but I think we're
designed
nearly there.
Designed by world-leading architects, the line is 500 meters tall, 200 meters wide.
So that's another one, is designed by architects. So guys, remember that we civil engineers later, we have to think how we're gonna be working. Architect got a vision, but we need to make it work. So that's another one here. And it's 500 meters tall. So imagine the one in London, the Shard, the tallest building in London is only 300 meters. And that line meant to be 170 kilometers long. So it's crazy, it's definitely something from the future.
And housed within an elegant mirror glass facade. Intelligent solutions create efficiency and year-round temperate microclimate with natural ventilation.
Yeah, so obviously the warm air going up and the cool air coming in, this was used 1,000 years ago. Obviously this is convection, the law of transfer of the temperature. But what I really like about it is actually taking that old knowledge and connecting with the cutting edge technology. The only problem here is, guys, this is in the middle of the desert, so the temperature is going to be around 40 degrees. But as far as I know, I think the temperature going to be dropping 1 degree every 100 meter. So that's going to be only 5 degrees less than at the bottom of that line. And let's be honest about it, that's 40 degrees, and even despite it's in the middle of the desert, the nights there, they're not going to be that cold to bring that cool air in. So I'm not really sure about what they got here, how they want to solve it.
Energy and water supplies are 100% renewable.
That sounds nice.
The line is designed as a series of unique communities, offering a wealth of amenities, providing equitable views and immediate access to the surrounding nature.
Sounds great.
With 40% of the world accessible within 6 hours.
40% of the world accessible within 6 hours. This is absolutely crazy. This is great. And you can have a look how that line is looking from
the
here.
The heart of the globe's key trade routes, a place for commerce and communities to thrive like nothing on earth seen before. The line. The city that delivers new wonders for the world.
Yeah, so it's definitely new wonders for the world. And stay with me, guys. I'm going to jump to the website there and let's have a look. Are they for real there, or is just a design for the future, far away, not even possible to do? Yeah, so that's their website. It's a Neom. So all that project here, it's done by Neom. And what we have a look here, I think that's the city here, the line. Yeah, it says... So it's some flying lady there. So to be honest, it more for me looks like a metaverse project than the real one to be done. But this guy's taking this for serious, guys. And let's have a look here what they got in news. Neom Now events. So we got the Neom launches public exhibition, share detailed design. So they actually got some detailed design. So they're taking it serious, guys. They want to build it. And despite it looks like taken for the future, it looks like impossible. Nothing is impossible, guys. And I definitely going to be keeping an eye on this project. And I'm going to keep you posted what's going on here. And the good thing about this project, guys, I actually found out here. They got that Roger Nickel, guys. And that guy worked for a Bureau Happold in London. He took part in projects like Battersea Power Station, where I myself took a little part, and he's the head of design and construction there. So having a guys like this, there is a small hope that it actually might be built. And I myself believe nothing is impossible, and I myself keep a fingers crossed for these guys. I believe everything is possible, so we just have to wait and see. But to be honest with you, at this point it looks more like a metaverse project, and I can't really imagine building like 170 kilometers long, 500 tall city now. So I believe Elon Musk first gonna fly to Mars before this gonna happen, but I'm not saying it not gonna happen. They're progressing with design, and I think they actually want to construct it. But remember, guys, this is Saudi Arabia there. So we had a promising Jeddah tower, which meant to be 1000 meters tall, and it's just on hold now. So they're dreaming big. This is good, guys. They got ingenious design, they actually implementing some projects there. But as Jeddah showed us, it's on hold, and this one I don't think it's gonna happen, but I really keep a fingers crossed, as I said. So guys, thank you for watching. If you like this video, just leave the thumbs up. I'm gonna leave the links below for all you've seen today. And yeah, subscribe to the channel if you want more civil engineering content. So thank you again, and see you next time.